He's got the body of Arnold Schwarzenegger, the toughness and tenacity of LT, and a good set of wheels to finish off a fast break. The one thing he doesn't have is an MVP trophy in his living room. Mark Schwartz has the story.
Neither Dwayne, nor Heat, nor McHale, not even Kite, can deter the mailman from the swift and gravity-defying completion of his appointed rounds. He's basketball's most ferocious finisher, a marvelous marriage of power and speed. In the top five in the MVP race, 3 years running, and three men have blocked his path to the pinnacle. But one has retired, another has regressed. But the third has soared to the top and threatens never to come down.
The Bulls have won 80% of their games this season, and Michael Jordan is the premier player in the league. I think you could make a case for Michael to be a unanimous MVP selection this season.
I doubt if I ever win it, really. And it's not something that's throughout my career is going to be a number one priority of mine. It used to be, but it's not anymore. So I guess when you grow up as a person and a player, those things become less and less important.
Carl seems to become more valuable every year. You know, he works on something every year. He started, as you know, and you know, as a poor free throw shooter and got that going.
A miserable 48% from the stripe as a rookie, Malone now lives at the line. In fact, he's made more free throws this season than anyone else has even attempted. In scoring, he trails only Jordan. He's a ravenous rebounder, and no one has hands like the mailman. Still, some who've watched his every move don't even consider Carl the MVP of SLC.
I think that we would win more games without Carl Malone than we would without John Stockton, because John is the leader of the team. Carl's not really a leader, and he'll get technical fouls every now and then, and he'll lose his cool.
You know, I think part of that comes with winning as well. You know, if you get to the finals, all of a sudden you become known as a leader if you're the star player.
But the NBA Finals remains a zip code unknown to Carl Malone. In fact, since 85, the Jazz have survived the first round only twice and have never reached the conference finals, while Jordan has led Chicago there three times in a row.
I think it boils down to where you are at the end of the year. I think that's what it boils down to, and that's what MVP means, that you put your team to another level, and we've been at the same level for 4 years.
Well, everyone expected them to win 50 games this year. Maybe if they won 60 or 70 games, then I could have voted for them.
Utah never has won more than 55 games, and the Jazz won't do it this year. And since 78, when Walton won, the MVP has guided his team to an average of 59 victories. In fact, the most common trait shared by NBA MVPs, their teams had the league's top record during the regular season. Second biggest factor, winning the scoring title. Jordan converts on both counts, which is why this race may be as one-sided as Airmail versus Pony Express. I'm Mark Schwartz for the NBA Today.